There we go. Be a terrible spot for it. Is this any better? I don't know. We'll find out. Up here, up there. Okay, let's just load it. Yeah, the baseball bat. That's the one. And then we'll worry about everything else later.
Sizes too small for my brain.
Max Payne. I envy your name.
Niagara.
You were smiling.
As in you cry a
pleased
lot.
Pleased to meet you. I'm Frankie the Bat Niagara.
Niagara. As in you cry a lot.
He had a baseball bat and I was tied to a chair. Pissing him off was the smart thing to do.
I'll be back to finish this off. And then, it's checkout time.
You play, you pay, you bastard. He swaggered out, the door clanged shut behind him, locks clicking in the bastard. Place. Everyone makes mistakes. Mine hadn't been to crack jokes about the goon with the bat. He'd have cracked my skull regardless.
Oops.
It hadn't even been to trust a girl with a gun. I had blindly gone after the first bad guy on my hit list when I should have been aiming further up the ladder.
What the?
At the head of the Punchinello family.
This guy, fuck.
I couldn't bring myself to be pissed at Mona. Guess I had a soft spot for a blue face.
Max, you big softy.
But when somebody decides to play baseball with your head, you tend to get sore. They had dragged me back to the basement of Lupino's hotel. I was beaten, bruised, and blue.
Kill for mother.
I felt like the chair I'd broken to get free.
Jason, come home. My special boy.
All I had was Niagara's bat, sticky with my own blood.
Yup. Okay, start this up.
Without a gun, I'd be no match for Frankie's men. I'd have to play hide-and-seek with him.
God, controls get more sensitive every time I try them. Ooh, that is where we go, but we'll wait. It's Frankie's turn. God, there's so many of them. Bam. Just like that. It's that easy, folks. Thank you. Nothing for me? Nothing? Okay. Alright, we're set. Let's get out of here and go find Frankie the Bat. Six rounds of 9mm Deathbringers. Oops, let's bring this down. There we go, let's see about that. Pain to the max. I think he just killed himself. Oh. There's stuff. So long.
Things were fast going from bad to worse.
Yeah, who killed all the cops? So I wanna know. Back at the hotel. Thought I'd killed everyone here already.
The men in blue had come and gone. They had decorated the place with chalk outlines and tied it together with yellow tape. Cops who had stayed behind were dead. Frankie, his boys, and I had the place all for ourselves.
Let's make some noise.
Just forget about it. Just forget about it. Hey, just forget about it.
Sometimes it just means...
That crazy witch, you should have heard her.
Forget
she was
about
a real scream when the boys caught her trying to cap the Don. Oh, that's friggin' bad. To the trio? That's even worse than what Frankie's doing to that poor bastard downstairs. She's gonna take a long time to die.
The mobster muscle on the phone was talking about Mona. Punchinello's trio were nothing but bad news.
Let's light him up. And... oh! To be found out so soon. What? Oh, man. Oh. I already cleared out this area before, so it looks like there's nothing left for me. Sensitive. No, radio, we'll let you go. I don't need to answer. This poor bastard. What the? Take that. Sure, let's use some grenades. Haven't done that in a minute. Max Payne.
The hotel bar was fast developing quite a history. True to his words, Frankie was there, having a beer.
Oh yeah, is Rob Job still around? You recognize what's up here? Rob Job?
What the hell, we could just as well finish this here.
Please speak, let me know you're still alive. Fine by me. Throw it! Boom. See you later, Frankie the Bat. Frankie the Bitch.
Thank you, thank you. You've been a lovely audience. Had enough? I don't play with girls anyway. Unfair!
I spotted the tail as soon as I left the hotel. A big black Mercedes. I'd seen the car before. That time it had heralded impressive explosions.
That's right.
Vladimir was back.
Bang. You're dead, Max Payne.
I might have laughed if I remembered how.
It's a pretty irrational fear, but I guess it happens, you know?
Look, you want something?
It'll happen in a New York minute.
Peace, man. Relax. You know you are a real news item. Armed and dangerous. I'm going to
now I think we head to the cargo ship.
Can't refuse. I've always wanted
think
to
so.
That.
It's a bum rap. I've been framed.
Well, that's a moot point.
Whatever that's
you
a
did
moot
or did
point.
Not do, I'm sure you had good reason for doing it. Want to hear me out?
I'm listening.
Oh, yes. Let's get a little... Ooh. It's like I'm just big enough to not be able to pretzel up in this chair. Don't like it.
Punchinello messing with V is bad for business all around.
Yeah, but that's right. The cult commando.
There is this
that
guy,
is coming up.
Boris Stein. Used to pull jobs for me. He's the captain of the
although
cargo
I think
ship
I'm a bigger fan of the
now
jackhammer.
Now that bastard turncoat has gone over to the
yeah,
other
you
side.
Get a little later.
The ship's loaded with high-res hardware. Guns. My business. If Punchinello gets hold of that cargo, he's won and I have lost. And you'll have your work cut out for you. If you want to get to Punchinello, you'll need heavy-duty persuaders. I am just the man to get them for you.
Very true, Vlad.
Change the ship back under my flag, maybe pop two in the traitor Dime's head while you're at it. You'll get enough guns to start the apocalypse. You in or out?
Let's get this show on the road.
Can't argue with that.
Vladimir was one of those old-time type guys with honor and morals, which made him almost one of the good guys. None of us was a saint. The Brooklyn Riverfront was a maze of rusty containers, sharp bone cranes looming up from the snowstorm. On a night like this, you couldn't help but think of the dark army of dead men sleeping with the fishes, cement shoes in line. No Minotaur lurked in this labyrinth, but somewhere out there, on the clanking deck of his cargo freighter, the skipper of the Charon was waiting, like the ferryman of the River Styx.
I don't like the pump-action shotgun in these games. You get one good shot, and then it's... Oh, boy. And then that's it. Spend the rest of the bullet time reloading.
They couldn't see in the end, swaying on their feet, slipping on
Do it, pal. Throw it down. Didn't give him the chance. Someone still around? Huh. Could have sworn I heard another voice. Oh, yep, I did. Isn't a limber man. He's pretty stiff. I don't think the jacket helps too much. Okay. Oh, good, good, good. Not that one. It's this one. Oh no, no, no. Let's signal Beretta for this. Oh my god, all that? Still didn't get him? Ooh, now let's go in. Oh shit. Oh boy. That was a disaster. Oh my god. I cannot believe you got me with that grenade. That's another real bummer about this game, and probably the same problem in the second one. If you already commit to bullet time and they throw a grenade, you just gotta eat it. you can't dodge it again. That sucks. Watch your head. Oh. Oh my god, where's my desert eagle ammo? Come on, fellas, drop some 50 cal. Okay, I think things start to get a little tougher around here. Just a little bit. A few more moving parts. Receive. There it is. Oops. Oh, no, 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 no. Alright, we'll just let him come to me. Why not? A little peekaboo action. Hello, goodbye. Oh, yeah. Gotta use this dang thing, don't I? Oh my god, I keep... Wow. It could have been on my head. I keep activating crouch. Every time he stops running, he starts crouching. I hate it. Oh, okay. This part can get a little annoying. Let's do it right the first time, shall we? Give me a cutscene. No cutscene. Alright, well. Have to multitask at a later time. Oh, no, this is the part. Yeah, fuck this guy. Two rounds, we can do it. Ready? Oh, no. He just took a round to the chest. Walk it off, big guy. Sorry.
Hold it.
Oh. It's Payne! Oh my god, there's that crouch button. The bridge. Okay, pal, it'll be your funeral. Just a
load.
Oh. Dang, he wasn't loaded there. Alright, we will let this one play out.
Rico Muerte have come to town to do more than just sort out family troubles. Exhibits number 1, 2, and 3. Briefcase of money, a sniper rifle, and an envelope with one word neatly printed on a folded piece of expensive paper.
Mayor.
It didn't sound like a mafia contract at all. It was too cold and too to the point.
Okay. Too cold, too to the point. Take me to Cold Steel. Blue Horseshoe loves Anacott Steel. Well, Payne. Oh, boy. Shotgun at close range. Not good. Okay, just keep popping those pills, Max. You'll be fine. Wow. Those Ingrams on range? They still got me. Oh, I see. Oh, there's a sharpshooter there. Well, let's just go ahead and put that in the butt, shall we? So long. Yes, give me your pills. Daddy needs his pills. Across the parking lot. Okay. Yes, but where? Where is that? Oh, it's right here. Oh! take us home. Switch out the Berettas for an indoor sniper. All right, come and get me. Be back to killing bad guys in just a second. What the? All right. Okay, let's go. Oh, see another. Wow, I got so lucky there. Instance of commit to the dive and then they throw a grenade. Nothing you can do. Oh, just like that! Fuck! Oh no! Jesus! Man, but at least you got that trench coat. That'll protect you from any damage. Any and all damage. Shrapnel, bullets, fire. Convenient shelf of ammo. Alright, pal, walk in a straight line. Can you do it? Say no pills, no thrills. Alright, this part is so annoying. But we'll do it. We'll get through it. Nothing as bad as the dreams, which I actually beat in my first try earlier, but it was not fun. Someone's firing at me. Oh, Jesus. Oh! Way to just alert him. What is happening here? Oh god. Fantabulous. Let's continue. Oh, yeah, you kind of have to control your running. I just had to, like, stutter step the entire time. So it's not fun to do, it's not fun to watch, and the sound design is just, oh, God. Everything about the dreams are just terrible. It's like the worst of the worst. So that's why I wanted to do it on my own time, in case I fudged it up. I could have sworn that door burst open, but... Aha. So... Oh, you duck your head, man. Okay. Now, back inside. Hello. Welcome to Max Payne Part 2. Thank you for checking it out. I'll most likely get all the way up to... Oh my fucking god. Can't you see I'm trying to talk? Just hold your fire for a minute, guys. Oh my god, I can't shoot for shit. Right. All right. So I'm gonna play. Oh my god. Up until the second dream sequence tonight. Most likely. We'll see how far we get. But that's the goal. And then play that on my own time. And then finish her out. You know, sometime early next week. Do do do. And then after that, maybe. Probably move on to Max Payne 2. Why not? But I would love to do Onimusha. I just started replaying that, and that game is tight. That's a lovely game. So that'll be on the menu soon. You know, some other day, some other time. We can unwind and kill. Oh my god. Demonic ninjas and samurais. The samurais. I don't know any ninjas in that. Anyway. Yes. The door behind the fence. And that's it. Fuck yeah, Max. Kick down that door. Let him know you're here.
Rust had crept over the sides of the cargo steamer a long time ago. Or his dime would be on board. I'd have to smoke half of his crew to even get near the gangplank. Guns were probably being kept in the hold, buried amidst the rats and oily water.
I don't know, Max. If there's one thing you do well, is you kill baddies. So, let's keep doing what you're good at, bud. Oh. You might not be a great cop, but you're one hell of a vigilante. Last thing I need is to get surprised by a shotgun. What the? Oh, there he is. Oh! Yes, I'll answer the phone. God.
Angie, tell me, how much did Dime cost you? I bet it was more than his name.
Max Payne.
Right the first time.
You're dead punk.
You sure you're not confusing me with Boris here?
You're dead punk.
But you are right, of course.
Right the first
Pretty
time.
Pretty soon we should get together and have a talk.
You motherfucker!
Pissing Punchinello off was a
you're
dangerous
dead.
Game. But when people get mad, they make mistakes. I should
Payne?
Know. That's what I wanted, Punchinello.
Right the first time.
Trip over his own feet, preferably into a grave.
In the wheel. Nice. Yeah, turn that boat.
You can't do this to me. You're a freaking cop.
He's blew himself up.
Yeah, keep telling yourself that.
Alright, let's get some. Ooh. Well, we'll just blast this guy real quick. And then we'll switch to the Ingrams. And we'll switch back to a grenade, because why not? No reaction?
Tell the devil that Dime sent you.
Whoa, what's going on with the screen? Oh, man. Oh, my God. Killed everyone but Dime? I must have shot Dime no less than, like, 200 times. Dead. Once again, with this duck button, I just cannot stop pressing it.
You know how to handle yourself. Anybody who says different is calling me a liar. Glad to meet you.
Alright, Max.
You want. Meet me on the bridge afterwards.
Now we're fully loaded. Let's go. Some ass for real.
Did you get everything you need?
Check.
I owe you. Anything you need.
This is my solo. When I'm through, Punchinello won't be anybody's problem anymore.
Who here has vodka? But anytime
yes.
You get between
Who
a rock and a
vodka?
Hard place, just whistle. This could be the beginning of a beautiful friendship.
You really get a bang out of this big-time gangster act, don't you? Even with all this firepower, I figured I couldn't get to Punchinello at his manor. I could only hope that he wouldn't pass a chance to hear me beg. You see, he's won.
Max
this is
Payne.
Max Payne. I want to cut a deal.
Okay, leave it at that.
Payne.
It's better.
You're a dead man.
That's what everybody keeps telling me. I got your ship and her cargo. I want to meet. No pain, no gain. Capiche?
You know my restaurant?
Yeah, I know it.
Wow.
Punchinello's restaurant had seen
right.
better days.
Have ourselves a nice sit-down meal, an espresso.
Snow
settle this like
ashes from post-apocalyptic skies, but that was outside. Things would soon get hot in the Don's restaurant. I knew it was a long shot. Angelo Punchinello actually showing up, but there was no crime in hoping.
Oh, yeah, this part sucks too. All right, let's hope we do it right the first time. It's a twofer. He has to kill Max and collect only insurance money. like it. Okay. Oh, oof. Oh, Max! You're a little too hot under the collar there, buddy. Alright, can't go upstairs. Oh, these stairs are open. Great. Now one turn has like a flying projectile coming at me. I gotta watch out for that. That always gets me. Yeah, fuck Don Punchinello. Dude sucks. Oh, Max. Is it? Yep. Holy Christ. Avoided. Wonderful.
The feeling is mutual.
Watch this. This is a nice trick.
Who's trying to put out my flames with gasoline? Mobsters have been guarding a real treasure. The way out of this disco inferno.
There he is.
What? Okay. Wow, they really just drop you right in the shit. Alright. Come on, game. Don't start bugging out now. Yeah, cute move, guy. Cute move, but I'm the only one who bullet dives around here. See, that's how it's done. Looks like I'm almost all out of Colt Commando. Came here to do two things. Kick some ass.
Glad to see my smoke signals. The Mercedes was revving the bell. Almost drowning out the Banshee well with the sirens.
You coming? We'll drop you off at the Punchinello Manor.
Sounds good to me. Hey,
when this is over, look me up. I could use a professional like you.
I'll keep that in mind.
Wow, I just got an email from Hillary Clinton.
Nervously.
She wants to meet me.
The falling snow was dead. That's white.
Amazing.
The darkness ate it up. I had heard the stories. The trio were mad dogs. They'd have hung the heads of their enemies over the manor gates if the capo had only let them. Punchinello wanted Payne. He'd see the pain.
Look at that face. He gets too much enjoyment out of this.
The trick in my situation was that there was no trick, no matter what the movies tell you. No rules, no secret mantra, no roadmap.
Just pop a bunch of pills and
good you were.
Go in guns blazing.
And luck. And anyone who thought different was a fool.
Go in guns akimbo.
All you could do was to hang on madly, as long and as hard as you could. Someone had graciously left the back door open for me and killed the guards. My money was on Mona. I knew the trio would be standing between me and Punchinello. I had read their rap sheets, fake as phone books. No one would be walking out of here alive. The numbing cold of the broken night had followed me in. Upstairs, the trio tangled down.
It looks like that second dream is kind of fast approaching us, so.
The blood of their victims rust on their lips.
Damn, I didn't think it would actually
Vince
be
Mignano. Pilot Providence, aka Big Brother.
So soon.
Joe Deadpan Salem. The pistol was a frozen lump in my hand, piercing the skin, gnawing me to the bone.
Wait, well, I can't use all that ammo just yet. Nothing? No. You want the pain? You'll see the pain. The pain. Oh. Oh man. Walked right into a trap there. Point. You guys deserve credit. I wonder what they see. It's like, I must move at the speed of light. He didn't even see me come in. The fuck was that? I mean, there's still a lot of gameplay left, you know, but I just didn't realize how short the time between dreams really was.
It didn't take me long to run into the trio.
Alright, let's raid the fridge. What do you got? Nothing. Anything in your cabinets? Nothing? Alright, the trio's in there. What do you got? Give me all you got. Two out of three? Let's see. Yep. Oof. Shit. Tables really. See ya. One out of three.
One down, two to go.
Desert Eagle will do. Nothing? Okay.
My fortune had been told.
Sure. Look at the cards, why not? Everyone loves a tarot reading.
The word on Lisa Puccinello is that she was a bit of a witch. The tarot cards on the kitchen table fit the picture. They weren't my kind of cards, but I was willing to take a crack at the hand Mrs. Puccinello had dealt. The first card was the tower. Maybe that was supposed to be the manor. It got easy after that. The devil was the master of the house, and death was me coming for him.
Very true. Very true. Max Payne is death personified. Angel of death. Wish I knew how to quit you, Beretta. I love. There's like nothing better than dual wielding pistols in video games. And in movies too, it looks cool. Ah, of course. Look, what do you know? Angel of Death. That guy's slick, hide behind that tree. Gotta love interactive environments. First one has like a couple. Second one, it's like every item is interactive. I'm just like to the point where it's ridiculous. So I just like kick up furniture in the air. Of the three trios is back. The three trios of the trio.
Payne's really over there. I want him dead.
Oh! What? Whoa! I didn't even see him throw that. Okay. No quick save in the PlayStation version, so who knows where they're gonna put time. Okay. We're right here. Cool, IRL. Is it freezing? Is there any AV issues beyond the usual? Yeah, I'm gonna dive in the same spot where I died last time. Bad idea. Bad idea. Bullet time and the shotgun just do not mix. Oh, there's another one. Okay, sounded like I got two of them. Let's see who's left. Lampanelli, Die Hard Dickweed, whatever his name was.
That's
Oh no! No, sir! Oh my god, he killed himself. Damn, that kinda fucked me up. Lisa Punchinello.
You're a real angel, Max.
I couldn't tell whether it was Mona or her sister. The body was a mess. The sick bastard had really gotten a kick out of it. Seeing her lying there got me thinking about another woman's body on another bed. Got me thinking about a fallen cradle.
Mm. Oh, Max. Oh my god, here it is. Really? The dream is about, you know, 5 minutes away. Dios mío, I don't want to do it. Damn it. Why? Might as well use the code commando. Bum,
Max Payne.
Talk to me.
Alfred Woden. You've got company. An armed helicopter just landed on the manor grounds.
Sure did.
You must hurry.
The more the merrier.
Okay, last of the trio. We go in just guns blazing. Oh, look at that. With my last.
Don't you know this trio was done for?
What we got? Ingram. Desert Eagle. Is that Lisa? After this cutscene, I mean, is it gonna be the end for tonight? I can't believe it's only an hour between sequences. That's ridiculous. Well, this just means that part three will be extra long because I don't think there are any rage quit moments between.
Puginello was a pushover. The moment I stepped into the room, he folded like a deuce before a royal flush.
We'll see.
No, wait. I was just doing what I was told. I couldn't refuse.
No, come on. You got the wrong guy.
Maybe. I don't know.
He was trying to buy
I'm
more
just
sand
a
for
pawn, baby. Please. You gotta just let me live. I'll do anything you want. Just please don't kill me.
I told him not to.
Oh, shit. Okay. Uh-oh. Oh, my God. I forgot that. She had to play for a second. Yeah, these goons. Snuck up on me there. Okay, but now. No, I didn't mean that. I meant now.
Got it. Don't move.
Game over, Max Payne.
When will I do it again? Probably just early next week. Monday, Tuesday. We'll see. We'll see.
I get to kill two birds with one stone.
Sooner or later, it was going to catch up with you.
Maybe Wednesday. I'm getting another tattoo Wednesday afternoon, so maybe afterward. Close out the night with part three of Max Payne. Vortex of green blood. But until then, well, you know,
gentlemen, we're
stay cool
here. Take me to cold steel.
Come next time and
she just give me an OD of Valkyr. I could
stick around for the whole thing.
My brains, they turned to steam. They did a fade on me. I never had a chance.
I'll wait until the cutscene's over before
I cut. The witch got me just as sure as if she put a gun to my head and pulled the trigger.
Yeah. A hot dose of V, but nothing can stop Max Payne.
The shadows rushed me. Bruised mugshot faces hungry for revenge. They knew my weak spots and closed in for the kill. The floor turned into a vortex of green blood. I fell.
No. I'll play you later. All right. Thanks for coming by.